studio whistle test in the new series. And through the programme, there'll be music from Little Feat, The Average White Band, Wally, and The Ronettes. And we'll be joined later on in the programme by Keith Richard. So, as a prelude to that, really, is some new film of the Rolling Stones and a track from their new album. This is Ain't Too Proud to Beg. Filmed by Michael Lindsay Hogg of the Rolling Stones, and some music from the new album It's Only Rock and Roll, called Ain't Too Proud to Beg. Well, I'm sure I don't have to talk again of my respect for the Rolling Stones and the things that they do, but it always is the greatest pleasure to welcome them to the studio. Bill Wyman joined us towards the end of the last series, and tonight, just a couple of weeks before the release of the Stones' new album It's Only Rock and Roll, it really is good to be able to welcome Keith Richard. How are you?
You're all right.
Keith, let's talk about the album to
sure,
start off with.
Yeah.
When did you record it? When was it finished?
Well, we started before Christmas, actually about 3 weeks after we finished the European tour, and we had Billy Preston with us, and we recorded in Munich, very good studio, and the band was very hot, coming off the road, you know, and so it's very fast. And we cut half the album in 2 weeks. Then everybody split for Christmas and everything, gorged and everything. After that, in about February, we came back to Munich again with Nicky Hopkins on keyboards and did another 2 weeks. And that was basically it. We'd cut enough tracks for like the album and some left over, you know.
Mm.
And after that, we left it until April, I think, when we came to London, Mick and I, to start doing the vocals, and that's the really hard work, the mixing. And
how long did the mixing take this time, Keith?
The mixing took about 6 weeks, 2 months altogether.
Mm. The team on the album really is very much the same, isn't it? Nicky and Billy Preston.
Yeah, yeah. Keyboards, and of course, Stu is on one. Our favourite pianist.
Yeah.
Our resident keyboard.
How does the production of a Stones album work, Keith? Is it basically really you and Meg?
Well, this time it was, because this is the first one we've done without Jimmy Miller.
Mm.
Since he did Beggar's Bank, was the first one, and he did Up Until Goat's Head Soup. And this one, we decided we'd like to have a go again ourselves. Mm. The last time was Satanic Majesties, which received mixed reviews. But it was, it's funny, it's quite easy to do it once you get into the rolling. And maybe because the band had come off the road, it was so much easier because everybody was into playing, you know.
Are all the band involved all the time with the recording of a Stones album?
Basically, everybody's together to cut the tracks. After that, everybody sort of disappears and leaves it to Mick and I, because they get confused after a while. And everybody sits in the studio saying, this should be louder, this should be... So we end up usually, Mick and I, struggling along by ourselves.
Because you yourself lately have been working with Ronnie Wood.
Yeah, I did.
How did that come about, Keith?
Well, that came about while Mick was doing a few difficult vocals on his own for an album. And I was sort of just hanging around, nothing to do particularly. One night Ronnie called me up and said, come down, I've got this fantastic rhythm section. Willie Weeks, Andy Newmark. Andy Newmark was with Sly, right, on the Fresh album. And Willie Weeks is known for his stuff with Donny Hathaway. And also, I think he's taken over sort of Chuck Rainey's position at Atlantic, doing Aretha sessions, you know. He's like a New York's hot bass player, you know. And I went down there just one night to see what was happening, and I got roped in to do a guitar overdub. And after that, I lived there for a month. I didn't see daylight again. And I got involved enough to write a couple of songs there, and I got to the point, I think, where Ronnie was sort of halfway through the album, and I said, I think it would be a good idea to do a couple of oldies, you know. I like doing oldies myself, it's a bit selfish. And and so we hunted around the old single pile, and we found Am I Groovin' You, a Freddie Scott oldie that Burt Burns wrote. And the old James Ray number, If You Gotta Make a Fool of Somebody, which was made famous by another English leaping gentleman. And it turned out very nice. It was a very nice balance of material, I thought. Mm. It turned out great. And to play with that rhythm section was enough of a turn on to do those gigs at the Kilburn stage.
Right. Yeah.
And all in all, very enjoyable for me.
Has that really sort of motivated you to do more things outside the Stones, Keith?
Well, I've got one little thing I want to do in Jamaica with some Rastafarians who, I don't know if we should explain any more about Rastafarians, but they're very heavy, happy dudes. And they play with drums and they chant, and they've got some amazing songs. And they sort of roped me in to play guitar because they'd never heard, they'd never had a guitar around before, you know. So they dragged me in there, and I got into it, and I got my reggae chops together. And so when I go back there, I'd like to sort of put it down on tape properly, you know.
Because do you get to see many bands yourself that maybe you would like to record. I mean, really, what I'm saying is perhaps, are you thinking about making the Rolling Stones label more active in that sense?
I'd love to. The idea's great, but by the time we've done our things, and what is it, it never seems to be time to really sort of go out and find a band that nobody's heard. And I'd love to. I mean, there's a lot of bands that I'd like to record, you know, just for the fun of it, like The Meters or Little Feet. You know, I mean, it would just be a gas just to do that, you know. But, well, that's another story, you know. I'd like to do it if there's any bands around.
What's happening in the future with the Stones now? Keith, are you planning a tour in the new year?
Yeah, I think that we should probably be going to the States in the spring. Instead, we were supposed originally to be going this year. It was sort of an inevitable thing, once every 2 years. But suddenly everybody got up and said, oh no, can't make it this year. We want to finish the record and get that done. And so we put it off until the spring, although maybe a few gigs around Christmas would be nice. I'd like to get on the stage again.
Because we were talking earlier now about the kind of venues that you're doing, Keith, and really they're enormous venues that you're playing.
Yeah, and they get bigger and bigger every time, you know.
Are you wanting, really, to do smaller things now?
Well, you know, it's kind of selfish to sort of go into a city where, say, 60,000 people want to see you and say, oh, we want to play in a 3,000-seater hall, you know, because the other 57,000 have to just lump it, you know. So the thing to do, I think, is to do the big ballpark and then do the small theatre as well, and so 63,000 people can attend.
How many people are involved now in getting a Stones tour on the road?
It's innumerable. I'm at 40 or 50 people carried about on an American tour. It's slightly less on a European gig, I think. But it's a lot of people, and it takes a lot of time to set the tours up, you know. Which maybe, I mean, if you're thinking of a tour in the spring, I guess they're starting to sort of get the venues together now, you know, or very shortly anyway.
Do you enjoy touring still?
I love it. It's the lifeblood for me. For any band, I think, any band that doesn't play live is only half a band, as far as I'm concerned, because that is where it all comes from, you know. And I think with this new album, there's a sort of feel about it, just because we'd come off stage just 3 weeks before and we'd been playing for 2 months solid, you know, and you can feel it, you know.
Yeah, that's true.
It's well oiled, you know.
So just finally, really, Keith, Britain, are there any plans now to play, I mean, aside from Christmas, are you thinking about a tour, really, for Britain?
I'd like to play England. We always have a good time touring England. And if it hasn't sunk before Christmas, I wouldn't mind doing a few gigs.
Keith, thanks for coming in to see us.
Okay, thank you, Bob. Nice to talk to you.
And don't forget that the new Stones album, It's Only Rock and Roll, gets its release on October the 18th. Right. Johnny Rivers and the excellent Andy Fairweather Lower here on next week's programme, so I hope you can join us for that.